I was saying you're going, Okudele. What is your problem? What's your problem? Calm down now.
Don't calm tell down. Me to calm down, Okudele. You cannot be poor and rude at the same time. Here, Harofu. In Anila, don't tell me to calm down. There's no drop of kerosene in this house. I'm hungry. I'm not eating. You're here shouting, bragging as if you need to warm
calm
house.
Down now.
I will not calm, calm down. Down. I need to warm my food and.
Hi people, welcome back to my channel. In case you've seen this channel for the very first time, my name is Angel and I'm currently based here in Lagos State, Nigeria. Rachel Okonkwo, popularly known as Nkoli Nwansuka, celebrated her birthday yesterday with this beautiful banging pictures you guys are seeing here. This lady you're seeing has been so hardworking. She's been doing so well for herself. And she's one of the celebrity that doesn't joke with girls' child. She's been seen all the time talking and advising young girls. I'm going to leave this video for you guys to watch and see how her birthday went, how she celebrated her birthday. Thank you guys, and please watch till the end.
You are excited to be here to be made some noise. I was called for this particular event. As an actor, they call me for different programs. But this is the second time I'm actually getting this kind of invitation to come and inspire, motivate, and talk to younger generation. I feel loved, I feel honored, and I'd like to say thank you to the organizers of this wonderful, insightful event. It's an honor to be here, and I'm humbled to be here. Tell the beautiful faces I'm seeing today that you are more. You are beautiful. You are strong. You are loving. You are amazing. Alright? I want you to keep saying that to yourself every day, because in life, what you say to yourself matters a lot. Someone can say you're ugly. Someone can say you're not intelligent. Someone can say you're not going to make it. Someone can say, oh, you're from a poor background. You're not going anywhere in life. But my question to you today is, what are you saying to yourself? I'd like to know what you are saying to yourself. Because whatever you're saying to yourself is definitely who and what you're going to become. As a girl, you cannot build a house. As a girl, oh, when you're single and you're driving car, who will marry you? As a girl, you can, don't let anybody limit you. Expand. Make your mother proud. It's good to be married and have a wonderful family. Companionship is amazing. But that's not all you can give to this generation. You can save lives. You can impact lives. You can talk to people. You can make a difference. You can make a history. Because your country well is married and she's a woman. And she's known all over the world, celebrated all over the world. Is it because she's a woman? No, it's because she's a great woman. And that journey we all are celebrating today did not start today. It started long, long, long time ago. Because I told you guys, when it comes to building greatness, when it comes to building quality, noble personality, it's a journey. Sometimes you want to go out for your lessons, you feel intimidated. And last Tuesday, I wore these clothes. Oh, I know that Choma will not wear her. Oh, no, she's changing clothes. I will not go. Are you there for clothes? Are you going for Choma? You're going for yourself. You're going for your parents. You're going so you can be the light that radiates around. You're going so you can make a difference. And while you are at it, trying to be someone in life, trying to work hard, trying to make a difference, trying to thrive, survive, expand. I would also want you to know one thing. You have to do all of this with moral standard. You have to do it with moral standard. You can have anything, you can have money, you can be famous, you can be a man of God, you can be anything you want to be. But do not forget, you need to build your moral standard, your values, your prestige. After your profession, that's the second thing people look at. Someone can say, oh, I love that medical doctor that attended to me the other time, but she's nasty. Why? She hasn't worked on herself as an individual. She might be doing well in her profession, but as a person, she's not the kind of person you want to have an encounter with the next time you meet her. You feel irritated. Why? There's no moral standard. Some people think people respect you when you are bossy, when you are disrespectful, when you are all over the place, when you are showing yourself for no need. No. It's only the stupid ones that will respect you for that. The real people will love you for who you are, for what you're doing, for what you're capable of doing, and the light they are seeing through you. Do not follow trend. Don't feel intimidated. Nobody is intimidating you. Most times you feel like, oh, she has it all, they have it all, I don't have anything, I am discouraged. My darling, use me as an example. Do not be discouraged. Keep working on yourself continuously. It's a continuous step. It's not something you do today, tomorrow you're tired, you want to give up, you feel you've done enough. And the truth is, it's quite discouraging. Oh, I've been reading, I didn't pass. Look at that girl. Now, the other day we were reading, she was playing football and today she passed. Most times, life is not like that. If you're going to be great in life, my darlings, life will challenge you. Sometimes you fail, not because you can't read, but God wants you to read more. Sometimes you fail, not because something happened, but that does not define you. Your failure does not define you. What defines you is what you do after you failed. Your ability to stand, your ability to read, regardless of the weakness, regardless of the discouraging. Because it's quite discouraging. In my field, sometimes I feel, oh, Rachel, I think you're not doing well. Then I said to myself, no, you're doing amazing. You've come this far. You're great. And the things to yourself matters. If you don't constantly say these great, great words to you, the insult or people's perception about you will bring you down. When I'm walking on the road, you look at me and I'm like, who is that stupid girl? I'll smile. You know why? Because I'm too much of a queen to be stupid. Don't always look for people who you're intelligent, you're this. People know that. Sometimes jealousy, envy, overwhelm them. It makes them not to appreciate you. But my question is, are you appreciating yourself as a girl child? Do you call yourself sometimes and say, girl, you've tried. Girl, you're doing well. I know last time you didn't really do well, but all along you've been doing well and I'm certain you're going to do great. That is the mindset. Results are out and yours is not all that fantastic. And probably your classmate or your friend is laughing at you. Ah, Kechi, so all that is in Asia. They say, yeah, I fell, but I will stand. You have to be conscious of who you are. Self-awareness. That is the only thing that motivates you to stand. Even when you are lying down there, weak, knackered, you say to yourself, I am rising up, I am standing. Nothing is keeping me. This is not where I belong. The world is waiting for you, for you, for you, for you to arrive. But my question is, where do you want to arrive? All of this we all are saying or are going to say today won't make any sense if you don't put it in practice and personally talk to yourself. Sometimes I call myself, I talk to myself, and it's very sacrosanct. You know what? Because most times when people talk to you, you feel insulted. Probably pride won't let you take that advice. But when you call yourself, you start to ask yourself a question. You reminisce on your past, background, present, future, who you want to be, where you're headed, what you want to be remembered for, most importantly. A lot of people are dead, but they are not, it's not everyone we remember and celebrate today, true of us. But there are some people that we all celebrate and remember them every day. Not because they lived, not because they were married, not because they were single, not because they are intelligent, they made a difference. I don't want you to be intelligent and it will just waste like that. You have good results, at your 30 you have nothing to write home about. It's good to acquire knowledge as much as you want, as much as you can. As a matter of fact, it's a journey that never ends. But aside speaking good English, aside your grades, when you're called up as a girl child, what will you be remembered for? At this point in time, your classmates, your school people, what do they remember you for when your name is mentioned? It starts from now. Don't wait till you get to 30. Don't wait till you get to 40. It might be too late. Yes, because at that point in time, you didn't build yourself to that level where you can handle the challenges. You've not made up your mind to be great, because when you make up your mind to be great, you also make up your mind to stand against anything that will stand in your way, because definitely a lot of things are going to stand in your way.